गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद द न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ सिविक्स, चैप्टर 1, द यूनियन लेजिस्लेचर एंड द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडेज टॉपिक इज द यूनियन पार्लियामेंट. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द फॉलोइंग पॉइंट्स. सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडे टॉपिक्स आर एज फॉलोज: फेडरल सेटअप, फेडरल फीचर्स ऑफ आर कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, डेफिनेशन ऑफ पार्लियामेंट. Before start the today's topics, let discuss some keywords. First word, manifests. It means express. Number 2, monarchy. It means a system of government or rule by a king or queen. Number 3, absolute. It means fixed. Number 4, democracy. A government by the people, for the people, of the people. Next word, dispenses. It means provide. Next word, federal. It means a form of government in which power is distributed between a central and state government. Number 7, federating. It means a number of states. Number 8, unitary government. It means a system of political organization with a central supreme government which holds the authority over the local government. Before start the today's topic, let's have some introduction about the topic. The Parliament of India is the supreme law-making body of the Republic of India. Republic means a country that has an elected government and an elected leader, president. It is a bicameral legislature composed of President of India and two houses, the Rajya Sabha and the Lok Sabha. Parliament is named differently in different countries. Like in Japan, it's named as Diet. USA, Congress. India, Sansad. Afghanistan, National Assembly, etc. Parliament House of India is situated at New Delhi. Chapter 1, Topic: The Union Parliament. The Union Parliament, in modern times, a state manifest means express itself through a government. It is the government which translates the aspirations, means desire, and ambitions, means goal, of a state into reality. Under a monarchy, monarchy means kingship. The king used to wield means controlled, power of the authority. Authority means command. His command was the law, his actions were absolute. Absolute means fixed and final, and his decisions were binding. Binding means permanent. But in the modern democratic states, means elected states, these functions are performed by distinct means well-defined wings of the government, which are more or less independent in their respective spheres. The lawmaking wing is called the legislature, the governing wing is called the executive, and the wing that dispenses, means provide justice, is called the judiciary. India, the largest democracy of the world, has the same setup. In modern times, a state expresses itself through a government. It is the government which expresses the desire and goal of a state into reality. Under a rule by king or queen, the king has full control on his state. His command was the law and his decisions were final and fixed. But in modern times, these functions are performed by well-defined wings of the government in democratic states. The wings are legislature, which is called lawmaking wing. Number 2, executive, which is called governing wing. Number 3, judiciary, whose function is to provide justice. India has the same setup as it has the largest democracy of the world. Federal setup. The Constitution of India has provided for a federal system of government. In a federal system of government, all the administrative powers are divided between the central and the state governments by the constitution, and both are supreme within their respective spheres: executive, legislature, and judiciary. Our constitution has provided a federal system of government in which administrative powers are divided between the central and the state government, and both are supreme within their spheres like executive, legislature, and judiciary. There are two types of federation: coming together federation and holding together federation. In the first category, independent states come together on their own to form a federation. Here, various constituent states are strong and enjoy powers at par. Par means equally with the central government. For example, USA, Australia. In holding together federation, a large country decides to divide its powers between the states and the central government. Here, central government is more powerful vice versa. It means alike. The states, India, Spain and Belgium are examples of holding together federation. In the whole world, there are two types of federation. Coming together federation, holding together federation. In the first category, all the states come together to form a federation and it enjoys equal power with the central government. Here, USA and Australia falls in this category. In the second category, a large country divides its powers between the center and the states. Here, central government is more powerful than the states. Here, India, Spain and Belgium falls in this category. Now, fact file. Though India is a federation, it is not like other federal systems. For example, the United States. In India, there is only one citizenship, one flag and one constitution. There is also single judiciary, not divided between the union and states. In India, there is a federal system of government, but it is totally different from the United States. In India, there is only one citizenship, but in United States, there is dual citizenship. In India, there is one constitution and one flag, but it is not in United States. They have two flags and two constitution. In India, there is single judiciary and the powers divided between the center and state. Our constitution has following federal features. Number one, the most important feature of the constitution of India is the supremacy of the written constitution, which is partly rigid and partly flexible. Rigid means inflexible. The federal features of constitutions are India constitution is the longest written constitution of any country. It is partially rigid, means which requires a special methods of amendment, and partially flexible means any of the provision can be amended by ordinary legislative process. Number two, the union as well as state governments derive means get their authority from the constitution. They have well defined and exclusive powers in the spheres of executive, legislature and judiciary. In our constitution, already defined about the powers of the central and state government in the spheres of executive, legislature and judiciary. Number three, the Supreme Court is the final interpreter, means translator and guardian of the constitution. Only the Supreme Court can settle disputes between the union government and state government or between the states themselves. The Supreme Court of India is the highest judicial court under the Constitution of India. It has the power to settle disputes between the center and state government and between the states themselves.
Chalo.
The Indian Constitution counters mean talk upon a federal system the strength of a unitary government. Though normally the system of government is federal, the constitution enables the federation to transform itself into a unitary state by the assumption means acceptance of the powers of state by the union during emergencies. Such a combination of federal and unitary systems in the same constitution is unique in the world. Normally we have federal system, but during emergencies the constitution allows to transform the federation into a unitary government. Such combination of federal and unitary system is unique in the world. Definition of a parliament. Parliament is the legislative. Legislative means lawmaking organ of the government. Here is a picture of Parliament House in New Delhi. It is a representative body whose permission is constitutionally required in the process of making or changing laws. It controls the Union Council of Ministers and National Budget. This clearly shows the principle of democratic government. Parliament is the law-making organ of the government. It is a representative body whose permission is required in the process of making any law or to change any laws. It controls the budget of the country and the Union Council ministers. The central legislature or the Indian Parliament consists of three constituents, the Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha and the President. Like several federations of the world, the Lok Sabha represents the people of the country and the Rajya Sabha represents the federating. Federating means number of states. The Indian Parliament, composed of President of India and two houses, Lok Sabha, which represents the people of the country, and Rajya Sabha, which represents the number of states. In this topic, we have discussed about the India's federal system is different from the United States. Let's make it more clear from the following chart. Difference between the federal system of United States and India. India. The Constitution of India is lengthy. The Constitution of United States is very precise, means exact. India has the parliamentary form of government. United States has the presidential form of government. The Constitution of India recognizes single citizenship. United States Constitution provides double citizenship. India has a single constitution. United States has a separate constitution for each state. We have also discussed about emergency in this topic, that during emergency, the constitution enables the federation to transform itself into a unitary state. Here I want to give one example of emergency that was imposed by Indira Gandhi. In India, the emergency refers to a 21-month period from 1975 to 1977 when Prime Minister Indira Gandhi had a state of emergency declared across the country. This emergency was officially issued by President Fakhruddin Ali Ahmed under Article 352 of the Constitution because of the internal disturbance. Thank you.